This channel is sponsored by Alpha Draft. Pick your custom LCS team and play them against me every week. Stay tuned after this video to see how you can join my weekly $25 RP giveaway. I was going to open up this video with a montage of this guy, but then I realized... how the fuck do you make a montage out of someone that looks like this? Welcome to League of Legends Actual Champion Spotlight, featuring Tom. Todd. This guy. This guy really isn't that bad. Trust me, I too was a pleb and I thought that this guy was the second coming of Bard on his first release, but in all honesty, he's actually pretty good. Not as a support and not as a top laner, but as a troll, I mean jungler. Holy shit, this is the first champion spotlight I'm doing on a jungler and I'm doing it on Tom Kench of all people. Where the fuck did I go wrong? I could have done one on Master Yi, Lee Sin, Gragas, Vi, but no. It's Tom Kench. Guess that's pretty, catfishy. Guido, I love you. Cinderhulk on Tom Kench, holy shit. It's like fucking Emma Stone and then having Katy Perry stop by and ask to join in. It's like taking a shit and then realizing you only have to wipe your ass twice. It's like seeing a female streamer say that you can add her on Snapchat if you subscribe, like it's some kind of extra bonus. This shit is fucking stupid because it does so well with the passive on your ult. But fuck your actual ult because it's only used to corral people like a sheep herder. If you wanted to do that, you could just play some kind of sheep herding game, like... sheep game. Get in the fucking barn! You get tanky in the jungle with a Cinderhulk, you grab a Righteous Glory and anything else that gives you health and just become this unkillable machine that can save your carries, catch out an enemy, tank damage, stun an enemy, and just do so much more than just sitting at bot lane throwing your tongue out like I should've just stuck to MapleStory.
Look at it, guys, it is, how long is it? 25 minutes in? Look at my score. I have participated in nothing. I have done jack shit.
You want to bring him top? Go ahead and feel free to get shit on by meta tops like Gnar, Renekton, Rumble, or anyone else. At least if you're in the jungle, if you die, you're just feeding the Krugs like an idiot.
You just ate a clone. Matt.
I got first blood.
It's Tom Kench, you're a tanky... Fuck, I can't do a look-a-tongue joke because Kyori already did that. Pokemon is my thing. Magikarp used fly. As Tom Kench, you're a tanky Sukumon. So, see what I did? That's a Digimon reference. Fucking Agumon used fly. This guy just says so much about my life right now. You're this tanky catfish that goes around insert obligatory eating out joke and spits them out like an insert obligatory porn joke. You get so tanky and your bullshit shield and heal lets you stay healthy in the jungle while still being able to duel other champions that try to invade you because Tom Kench is such a bad champion, right? Plus, you can fight blue buff with Gromp and, you know, that's pretty funny. Also, I don't know why, but sometimes when I play Tom Kench, he makes enemy minions or Heimerdinger turrets immune to any other damage except for his Q. The fuck is this shit? Your passive and acquired taste applies a stack where every, you guessed it, 3 auto attacks gives your Q and W extra effects. Your Q is tongue lash. You lash out your tongue and hit the first enemy, slowing them for 2 seconds. But if your passive is stacked up, instead of slowing the enemy, you stun them for 1.5 seconds. Hitting an enemy with your Q and adding some CDR, you can stack your passive and completely catch people off guard with how much a giant walking fish can stick to you. It also has a hidden passive where you feel super awkward when you use his ability against Lucian since you're basically giving him a lashing. That's fucking weird. And then you've got your W called Devour.
I'm gonna need you to escape, dude.
Yeah.
All creation is born, famished and
destroyed. Oh!
I told you I needed you, man!
When activated on an ally, you can eat them and make them untargetable or perform any actions for a short amount of time while also gaining a movement speed buff. If you have your passive stacked on an enemy, you can then eat them while slowing down your movement speed. After 2 seconds, you can then regurgitate whoever is inside of you and spit them out, dealing max health damage that scales with your AP. The damage on this thing is fucking ridiculous. 32% max health damage that scales with your AP. That's almost 50%, which is almost 100%, which means you basically killed them. Trust me, I'm a math doctor. Eating an ally, they have the ability to exit once the 4-second duration is over, but before that, you have that glorious 4-second window to troll the fuck out of them. Thank you. Throwing aside, you can also use your Q and W together in order to pick up a minion and shoot them back out at your enemy, which is awesome. It provides a shit ton of poke and also deals splash damage, so you can get some nice chunks in between fights to soften up the enemy team. Even though you can eat the enemy, that doesn't mean you should. It's like Blitzcrank, even though you pull someone, if no one's around to help you out, you're probably going to die. So if you see this, don't automatically think you need to eat them. Instead, it's a lot better to just eat one of your carries when they get out of position or about to take a bunch of damage. You can get a lot more saves this way, and also gives you a movement speed buff so you can reposition them to the back of your team. Holy shit, that was a lot of information. I should probably say a joke right now. The League of Legends subreddit page. Thick skin is your E, and holy balls, there's so much more to say about this champion. Why does every skill have a passive and an active plus a fucking paragraph of math? I'm gonna kill myself when I do an elite spotlight. Yeah, Darius's grab is fucking bullshit. So Thick Skin's passive is that he stores all the damage he takes as gray health. You guys went through all this trouble making shit up like energy, fury, and rage, but you call this gray health. Hello, creative team. So you get this gray health that you put onto your health bar so people like Sneaky can't see, and it converts 20 to 44% of it into health that Tom regens after not taking damage for 2.5 seconds. You can also activate this spell to gain a shield for all the fucking damage you've taken that slowly decays over 6 seconds. Jesus, fuck on a pole stick. The hell is this shit? The shield you get on this thing is bigger than Misfortune's tits. Every damage that you take becomes a fucking shield. Are you kidding me? Jesus Christ, put a Lulu shield, a Janna shield, and a goddamn new car into that gray fuckfest and just look at this guy never die while killing the entire enemy team. My god, castrate this tough skin because you're never going to kill this guy before he can deal his 32% health damage shred on your ass so out of breath. Jesus Christ. So, back in high school, I was talking to my friends because my grandfather had just died and I was telling them how we cremated him, but I was super high at the time. And I mixed up the word cremate and castrate together. And so I had told them that we castrated my grandfather and put his remains in an urn to spread across the Grand Canyon later. So they got super confused and asked why the hell we did that. And I just said it was a family tradition. And yeah, I didn't realize until later that I fucked up. So, you know, there you go. I hope that helps you learn how to play Tom Kench. Your ult is Abyssal Voyage. Again, it has a passive and an active. Jeez, Riot, please. The passive is what makes Tom Kench so strong. Each basic attack deals 20 bonus magic damage plus 48% of your bonus health. Group this with your Cinderhulk and all the tanky as fuck health items, and this guy is going to hit harder than a truck hitting something that would be that would probably make this joke viable. I'm running out of shit to say about this guy. I mean, for God's sake, I even told a story about castrating my grandfather in this video. How much fucking shit have we covered? You can also activate your ult to go from point A to point B while also having an ally inside you to teleport them just like a TF ult. So just like Rek'Sai, if you take any damage, your channel will also be interrupted. But regardless, when you pop up after a million years and then some when everyone's done playing the game and they're off playing like Minecraft, you'll pop up with your dick in your hand looking like an idiot because everyone just looks at your ult and says, yeah, fuck that, I'll go this way. Instead, don't try to use it as an engage, but use it more as a way to pick up stragglers or to help move people to another part of the map so your team can come and pincer your enemy. You grab some attack speed runes to go into the jungle with some scaling CDR blues while also going 921 in your masteries. You max your W first and shit on Gromp and then max your E or Q second depending on how the game goes. Holy shit, I think that's it. Is that? Oh my god, it's like I ran an entire fucking marathon. Ugh. So yeah, that's Tom Kench. He's strong. I don't know, I feel like that he's... I'm gonna go play Sheep Game now. Get in the fucking barn!
Squeesh.
And that's another champion spotlight in the can, baby! Yeah. Alright, if you liked it, I hope you touch yourself at night because the Tooth Fairy enjoys that kind of shit. Thanks again to Alpha Draft for helping me be able to release these videos every week, and I sent out an email to everyone that won the RP giveaway last week, so make sure that you check your emails to see if you won. And if you want to join this week's RP giveaway, just check out the links below. If you want to play some games with me, be sure to join the Carp Crew chat room on League of Legends, because I'll be doing a bunch of custom games from here on out, and who knows, maybe you'll be in my next video. God damn. I think this is the longest video I've released on this channel. What? I wonder how much longer I can make it. Here's my impression of a Japanese guy trying to do a German accent.
Hello, camarader. I enjoy drinking vodka with my comrades and...
That might be a little bit racist. So, if you're still here, tweet me, tweet at me, the funniest picture you've seen online, and I'll put my favorite tweet in my next video. That sounds cool.
Korea! Korea!
If you're actually still here, tweet me a fan fiction. I'll read and I'll make an entire video of my favorite one. Now, if you're a true fan and you're still here, believe it or not, I'm walking on air. Never thought I could feel this way. Believe it or not, hey.